today we are going to learn about granulation equipments, or we also called it as a granulators. Now in granulation equipments we are going to learn about various granulators which are used for wet granulation as well as which are used for dry granulation techniques. Now initially we will look towards the learning objectives of today's lecture. Okay, after completing this video lecture you will able to firstly understand various equipments used for the granulation, and secondly you will able to visualize construction and working mechanism of granulators. Means in this lecture we are not just only going to show you a PowerPoint slides. In this current lecture we are going to I am going to show you various videos that will betterly explain you what is the mechanism of working of that particular granulators. Now we will start with first, that is granulation equipments. Now granulation equipments are of initially two types, that is wet granulators and secondly dry granulators. Now wet granulators is again fall into the three categories. First category is called as a shear granulators, second is called as a high speed mixer granulators, and third one is called as a fluidized bed granulators. Okay, these are the three basic classes of wet granulators. Among these classes there is again different types of granulators that we are going to see in the next subsequent slides. Then in a dry granulators, generally we are using slugging techniques, and secondly we are using roller compactor, or we also call it as a chilsonator. Okay, then in shear granulator there is only one granulator we are using for the granulation, we called it as a planetary mixer. And in case of high speed mixer or granulators, there are again three different types of granulators. In that, first Dyson granulator, second Colette Graal type of granulator, and last one is a oscillating granulator. Okay, these are the three different types of high speed mixer granulators. Then fluidized bed granulator, as it is a different granulator for a or a different mechanism of granulator. Means this granulation classification we have done on the basis of their mechanism of working or construction and working. Depending on which mechanism they are working, depending on that we have classified various granulating or granulation equipments. In that, firstly shear granulators means what? In that, only shear force we are using for the granulation. It is simply like a mixers. Okay, it is simply like a mixer granulators. And secondly, high speed mixer granulators now arise and most widely used in a pharmaceutical industry. In that, there is a high speed mixers we are using for the granulation purpose. And these three high speed mixers is of three types, that is Dyson granulator, Colette Graal type, and oscillating granulator. From these granulators we can able to prepare a granules in a wet granulation. Fluidized bed granulation, in this we are generally using a fluidized air for the purpose of granulation, so that we are called it as a fluidized bed granulators. And in dry granulation, last lecture also we have seen the little bit about slugging and roller compactor. In this lecture we are going to see in detail about these granulators. Now firstly we'll start with the wet granulators. Now in a wet granulators there are three main types of wet granulators in wet granulation used in a pharmaceutical industry. Okay, the first mechanism is shear granulators, second high speed mixer granulators, and thirdly fluidized bed granulators. Now we'll look for the first, that is shear granulators. Now in what happened in a shear granulator, the dye powder blending usually has to be performed as a separate initial operation. In this particular granulation we cannot do the mixing of powder, we need to do it separately, and then we need to use that powder blend for the granulation. In this particular shear type of granulator, the only one granulator is there, that is a planetary mixer or planetary granulators, using different powder or mixing equipments. Now the disadvantage of this particular shear granulator is that it takes a long duration for the granulation process. That is the major disadvantage of shear granulator. Then for this shear granulation process, the need for several pieces of equipments. We will require separate equipments for the mixing, we will require separate equipment for the preparation of binder solution. Okay, for that the need of several pieces of equipment, that is also a disadvantage of shear granulator, and this is also the material loss in this particular shear granulators is very high as compared to the next one, that is whatever high speed mixer granulators. Now we firstly see the planetary mixer granulators. Now in this figure you can observe this is a planetary mixer for wet massing. We can generally using this is a mixing arm, okay, which is will this is a mixing bowl in which your powder blend is there, and this mixing arm is continuously rotating in this powder bed or powder bowl, so that it will uniformly mix your binder solution throughout the wet mass, and finally it will form a granules, okay. But the problem is with this mixer is that we need to prepare a powder blend separately. Means whatever your excipients are there, and your drug, your excipients like a diluent, binder, disintegrants, they will its blend we need to prepare separately, and then we need to add that blend in that particular mixing bowl, and due to that it will require large process, it will take more time, it will require more pieces of equipments, and due to these subsequent processes there is a loss of material is also high. Now I am asking you a question, why this particular mixer is called as a planetary mixer? Kindly unmute any one of you and tell me why this mixer is called as a planetary mixer. Am I audible? Hello? आवाज येतोय का?
आवाज येतोय सर.
ओके, कॅन एनी वन टेल मी वाय वी दिस पर्टिक्युलर ग्रॅन्युलेटर वी कॅन कॉल इट ॲज अ प्लॅनेटरी मिक्सर ऑर प्लॅनेटरी ग्रॅन्युलेटर वी कॅन से. द टायटल इट सेल्फ इंडिकेट्स वाय वी कॉल इट ॲज अ प्लॅनेटरी. वॉट डज इट मीन्स वाय वी कॉल इट ॲज अ प्लॅनेटरी? इफ यू नो द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस वर्ड you can able to tell me why we called this mixer as a planetary mixer. Is there anyone? Just give me answer. If you are wrong, I am going to correct you, no problem. You can give me answer. If it is wrong, then also it is not a problem. Just try, anyone, or else I will not go forward.
Faster mixing in lesser time.
Yes, for
mixing and time taken is less.
Okay, what is the meaning of planetary? Tell me that. What do you mean by planet? Forget about planetary, tell me what do you mean by planet?
Sir, it moves
bodies.
The
bodies move. Yes, the movement. Yes, tell me, that is right.
Movement in one direction.
Okay, movement in one direction, you are little bit correct, but the movement I am asking about the word planet, it is related with the movement of planet. Means what? Planet means what?
Went on a single axis.
Okay, now consider the example of our planet Earth. Okay, all of you know that Earth revolves itself, okay, around itself also, and it revolves around the sun also. Okay, the movement of this mixer is also the same. Means now consider this mixing arm is our Earth or our planet. Okay, that mixing arm will rotate itself around, and again it will rotate around this mixing bowl also. Means this particular movement is just like a planet. Whatever the planets present in our galaxy, they will move around themselves also, and they will move around sun also. Okay, that is the movement, and same movement you can observe in this mixture. That's why this mixture is called as a planetary mixture. Now this arm, in this figure it is shown that only one arm is there, but in case of planetary mixer there are number of arms available for this mixing. Now you will see a simple video of this planetary mixer and then you will understand betterly. Now you can observe this is a planetary mixer which is having a motor at the top of this particular mixer which will rotate your shafts. Now you can observe these are the various shafts. Okay, look at the pointer where I am rotating my pointer. You can look at the pointer. These are the various shafts present in a this particular mixer. How these shafts are rotating? Look at the shafts. You will get the answer. They will rotating around themselves. And now we are filling our all the material in this planetary mixer. That is our we can say all the material that we want to mix in this. Now you can observe the mixing process. How it will mix your and it will form a wet mass. During this mixing only we are going to add our binder solution so that it will mix well and it will give you a granules. Okay, this is a mixer movement. You can observe these shafts will move around themselves also and inside the bowl also. Okay, completely it will move around the that bowl. This movement is called as a planetary movement. That's why this mixer is called as a planetary mixer or planetary granulator. This mixer is used for both purpose. We can use it for the mixing of ingredients also, and we can use it for the preparation of wet mass. Now this wet mass is prepared, and by this action we can simply remove this wet mass through this particular planetary mixer. Okay, just look at the video, you will get a clear idea. Okay, these are the first mixing shafts and this is a mixing bowl. Okay, these are the mixing shafts and they will rotate around themselves also and inside the mixing bowl also. Okay, this is the inside view of this particular planetary mixer, and here we can see the sprayer will available. From that we can able to spray our binder solution also, and we can clean our mixer also. Okay, this is all about the first planetary mixer. Did you understand? Now we will start with the next. That is, first bit we have finished, that is shear granulators, in that planetary mixer granulator, or it is simply called as a planetary granulator. Why we called it as a planetary? Because the movement of this mixer is same like a movement of planets. That's why it is majorly called as a planetary mixer. Now second mechanism of working in a wet granulators is that high speed mixer granulators or high speed mixers. Generally these are also a mixer, but they are having a high speed. They are operating at a very high speed. That's why we call them as a high speed mixers, or it is also used for the granulators. In that, first one is a Diasna granulator. Now Diasna granulator is that in this granulator you can observe here in this figure. Okay, there is a one three bladed impeller. Okay, you can observe here this blue color, just a two blades, and third blade is behind this particular triangle. You can betterly observe it in a video. And secondly, one a chopper. Okay, whatever the material you are using for the granulation, you can feed it by using outlet filter. Okay, from here you can fill the material and then you can start that particular chopper, and you can add a binder solution, then it will form a wet mass. Now this wet mass is to be break in a different we can say different sizes. Okay, we can need to break it in a different sizes so that it will get converted into a granules. Okay, for that purpose we need to use this chopper. This chopper blade is required, this second blade, that is chopper blade. The chopper blade will break down the wet mass whatever form in this particular high speed Diasna granulator, and from that, after completion of your granulation, there is a discharge port. We can open this discharge port and you can collect your granules from here. And this is a drive motor. There is a motor present which will rotate your three-bladed impeller throughout your mixers. Okay, now we will look a simple video about this and you will get a clear idea about the Diosna granulator. High shear granulator, the GLAT process technology. They will provide you, or they will provide the granulators for industry. Now you can observe, this is our mixing bowl. Just look at the video, you will get a clear idea how it will form. Okay, this is our mixing bowl, in which and below that there is a drive motor. Okay, now this is a three-bladed impeller. Okay, three-bladed impeller, we are adding our material in that particular granulator. Okay, here you can observe, this is a chopper. Now we are mixing and we are continuously adding a granulating fluid so that it will form aggregates of particles. You can observe it in a separate window here. In this window you can observe how it will form aggregates of particles. Now these aggregates, this wet mass is finely chopped by using this chopper blade. The chopper blade will again break down this. Okay, that particular chopper blade will continuously break down this particular from, and it will form a granules. Now these granules are formed, this movement, the direction of movement, it is showing that it is revolving like this and the chopper will revolve like this. Okay, now granulation process is completed. Now we are discharging our granules. How the discharging is details. Now details of this machine, they are going to show you. Look at the details. This is our Z-shaped rotor, or we can say in figure we have seen three-bladed mixers, chopper, three-bladed impeller, then cross-blade chopper. This is a chopper present in this particular mixer. Okay, and that particular chopper will have ability to chop down the weight mass and convert it into the granules. We will see some specification of this Diosna granulator. Okay, now this type of granulator is used extensively for pharmaceutical granulation. Mostly it is used in a pharmaceutical granulation. The machines have stainless steel mixing bowl, means whatever the mixing bowl is there, it is of stainless steel, and a three-bladed impeller which revolves in a horizontal plane 150 to 300 rpm. That is important, its specification. That means whatever that three-bladed mixer is there which will revolve, impeller is there which will revolve in 150 to 300 rpm. Now three-bladed auxiliary chopper, that's a second chopper, or breaker blade also we can call it as a breaker blade, which revolves in either the vertical or horizontal plane in 150 to 300 rpm. Means whatever your three-bladed impeller is there, its speed is 150 to 300 rpm, and whatever the three-bladed chopper is there which will able to cut down your weight mass or chop down your weight mass, which is around 1500 to 3000 rpm. okay, the chopper is usually switched on when the moist mass is formed, as it is its function is to break up the weight mass. Means when we need to start the chopper, once your weight mass is formed, then we can go and we can start the chopper, and then chopper will start breaking up your weight mass and converting them it into granules. Then whatever the bowl volume of that granules will be 1 liter and 1250 liters are available. Means the models are available from the various sizes range, starting from 1 liter model to the 1250 liter models. Okay, 1 liter model we can say it is a laboratory grade model, and 1250 liter it is a industrial scale model. Okay, these are the various bowl volumes you can available for this particular Diosna granulator. Okay, now next we will start with the collet graal type of granulator. Now collet graal type of granulator is a granulator which is similar to your we can say Diosna granulator, but the just a replacement of Diosna granulator bowl with this particular setting. That is, mixing bowl is composed of three bladed mixing shaft instead of three bladed impeller. Okay, three bladed impeller will get replaced with a three bladed mixing shaft, and chopper will also get replaced by in a vertical direction. That is the only difference between collet graal and Diosna granulator. Okay, now we will look toward the video of collet graal type of granulator, that is planetary granulation, high speed collet graal type of granulation, or diastema granulator is unable to produce a granules of your required size. If it is not produced in a required size, then we can use oscillating granulator. This is a video of oscillating granulators, how it will work. Observe here, these are the rotors. Okay, these are the oscillating rotors. Okay, through this your material will be over here. That material will form these oscillating rotors and will move. Now at the bottom you can observe here, there is a screen. Now look the mechanism, how it will work. Okay, these are the rotors, oscillating rotors. Here is a, you can observe, there is a basic screen. Here is the screen or sieve, we can say. Now we are adding material over these rotors. Look at this, how these rotors are moving. These are the rotors continuously moving. And this is a chopping. Actually, here is a chopping will occur. The weight mass is completely break here. Here the weight mass is completely broken. To that moment, the breaking of weight mass is possible in the oscillating granulators. Mechanism, how it will convert your granules in a uniform size. Now we are adjusting the screen, the mixing rotor, and now see the action, how it will cut down the material. Now we are placing the material, and this material will get passed through this below screen. Whatever the screen is there below, it will get passed, and you will get a uniform status. Now we will look towards the some facts about the oscillating granulation. An attractive feature of high speed granulator is too is the fact that the product is usually granular and separate step to granulate the weight mass is avoided. Okay, whatever the major role of high speed granulators, that is the product is usually granular and separate step for granulation and the weight mass is avoided, means we can do the together granulation and weight massing will be together in high speed granulation. But this condition is not arise or not we can say give satisfactory results always. Okay, so that occasionally this is not fully satisfied and the moist mass has then to be transferred to a granulator such as oscillating granulator. Means as it is your high speed mixer granulators sometimes will not able to produce your granules and weight mass together. Means they will only produce a weight mass, better weight mass, but unable to produce a uniform size of granules. In that case, we need to add this weight mass form in a high speed granulator into the oscillating granulator, and then that oscillating granulator will convert them into a uniform size of granules. The rotor bars, whatever the rotor bars we have seen in a video and in your diagram also, the granulator oscillates at an adjustable rate between 60 to 100 RPM. Means whatever these rotor bars are there, they will oscillate in between 60 to 100 RPM, and we can adjust them depending on our need. We can adjust them in between 60 to 100 RPM. Then the force of the moist mass through the sieve screen, means whatever these oscillating bars will force the moist mass through the sieve screen, and the size of which determines the granular size. Means the size of your sieve screen will determine the size of your granule size. Okay. Now next and most important and mostly used granulator, this is all about, we have finished with the high speed mixer granulators, three mixer granulators. Which are these three? First one is a diastema granulator, second one is a collet graal type of granulator, and third one is a oscillating granulator. These are all are these all are high speed granulators. Now we will look towards the third mechanism, that is fluidized bed granulator. And this is the most widely used granulator in the pharmaceutical industry for the granulation because of its high efficiency, which will give you a high efficient uniform size of granules. Okay, that's why fluidized bed granulator is a popular granulator in pharmaceutical industry. Now we will look towards initially the figure, then we will look a video. Now in this figure you can observe this dotted line is your mesh screen. Okay, here you can observe the filter which will supply the inlet air, which will supply the inlet air in this particular, and your material is fall over the screen. Whatever the material you want to convert them into granules, it will form. The inlet air will pump out the fluidized air, and your material will start revolving in this particular chamber. It will continuously revolve like this. Okay, what, look at the movement of my arrow or pointer. You will get back there. It will move like this in this particular moment in about direction. Okay, and during that movement, now we will start a spraying of our granulating fluid. That's through that spray nozzle. Through that spray nozzle, we are continuously spraying our binder solution of granulating fluid, which will promote the formation of granules while they are in a revolving state. And then we can stop. And ultimately, if you are providing the fluidized air in a hot air, then the drying and formation of your granules at a simultaneous level. So that this particular fluidized bed granulator is quite used in a pharmaceutical industry as a granulating granules. Now you can observe here we have put our material charging process, we can call it as a, we can charge our granulator with whatever the material we have to produce 6 granules. Then we are starting fluidized air. Okay, due to that the material will start revolving or float in this chamber. Okay, the fluidized air, the red arrows will show you the direction of fluidized air, and due to that high pressure fluidized air, the movement will start. And this is actually a spraying nozzle. Through that we are spraying our material, and here you can observe in separate window how that binder solution will form agglomerates of particles or aggregations of particles and convert them into granules. You can observe in a separate window also the process. Now drying process, same air we can replace with the hot air. Now the drying will start, the granules will become a dry. Now fluidization we can off, the granules will settle down and ready for discharging. We are discharging now granules, we will get ready granules which are uniform size, which are completely dry. Now we will see the details. Now this is exhaust filters. At the top of this particular equipment you can observe the exhaust filter. Okay, due to that, due to the fluidization, whatever the dusting will happens, that dust will not come out the your granulator. This is a top gray gun spray nozzle. This spray nozzle we can generally use for the spraying of our binder solution. By this mechanism we can spray atomizing air and spray liquid, we can continuously add in this spray nozzle, and due to that there is a formation of misty spray and it will continuously form granules. This is all about the fluidized bed granulation. Okay, this is the exhaust filter. Whatever we have seen in a video, these are the exhaust filter, means whatever the fluidized air will come with this air, there is a chances of whatever the powder material is there, which will again come out from the air outlet. Okay, to avoid that powder material get out from your fluidized bed granulator, these are the exhaust filter. They will trap that powder material and again put them into a mixing chamber so that this powder material is available for the granulation. Now we'll look little bit facts about the fluidized bed granulator. Now in fluidized bed granulator, the large producer or whoever the supplying the fluidized bed granulator to the industry are Aromatic Filter and GLAD and Vanguard. These are the three companies. These will give the fluidized bed granulator to the pharmaceutical industry. They are the manufacturer of fluidized bed granulators. And their working design is same as a fluidized bed dryers. Okay, fluidized bed dryers You can observe this fluidized bed technology is applicable for all drying purpose. Also, we are using fluidized bed for granulating purpose. Also, we are using fluidized bed and for coating purpose. Whenever we are going to see the tablet coating, in that also we are see the fluidized bed coater. In that also we are going to use the fluidized bed techniques. All are working in the same we can say principle, that is fluidized bed. Okay, but the little bit variation in your equipment, it will act as a dryer, it will act as a granulator, and it will act as a coater also. Okay, in subsequent lecture we are going to study also fluidized bed granulator, so that you will come to know the difference between granulator and fluidized bed coater. Then the next is that the powder particles are fluidized in the stream of air, but in addition to granulation, fluid is spread from the nozzle onto the bed powders. Means initially we are starting the fluidized stream of air, and then we are starting the spray nozzle to spray the binder solution over the powder. Then granulating fluid is pumped from the reservoir through a spray nozzle or multiple nozzles positioned over the bed of particles. You can place a one nozzle, or you can place a multiple nozzles for the spraying of granulating fluids in a fluidized bed granulators. The granulating fluid causes the primary powder particles, means whatever the initial powder particles are there, to each other, and when the droplets and powders collides. Okay, due to that granulating fluid, the primary particles and droplets, when they will get colloid, then it will form a granules. They will make adhere two primary particles to each other. Then laboratory models of this particular fluidized bed granulator is available in between 0.2 to 2 liters, and giving a capacity of few grams to about 1 kg. Okay, means we can process for laboratory use. It is available in 0.2 to 2 liters and 1 kg, up to 1 kg we can process the granulation. But for production volumes, large production volumes, it is also available from 5 kg to massive 1550 kg. Okay, for production volume, it is maximumly available for 1500, means we can simply say up to 1.5 ton. Up to that much large size of batch we can manufacture in a fluidized bed granulator. These are generally used, production volumes generally used in a industry, but not in a laboratory models. Laboratory models we can use in a colleges or in a research institute. Generally laboratory models are used for the fluidized bed granulation. This is all about the wet granulation techniques or wet granulators, whatever the wet granulators we are using. Now we are going to start with the dry granulation. Now dry granulation is generally the process which converts primary powder particles into granules using application of pressure. That is important point. Here we are not spraying or we are not adding any liquid material, but we are preparing this granule by just applying a pressure. Okay, without intermediate use of liquid. We are not using any liquid for the preparation of dry granules. Okay, it is therefore avoids heat temperature combination which may degrade the product. That is the we can say advantage of dry granulation. Therefore we don't need a drying of these granules. Okay, and due to that, there is, we are always avoiding heat and temperature combination, which sometimes may leads to the degradation of products. Now two pieces of equipments are necessary for dry granulation. First is a machine for compressing a dry powder into compacts or flakes. You will require a machine which will compress your powder into a compacts or flakes, and secondly a mill to break up this intermediate product into a granules. Then secondly we will again break these compacts or flakes into a different parts so that it will get converted into a granules. Okay, that is techniques of these granulators. Means any dry granulators, initially you will require a machine for the compression and formation of a compacts, and secondly we will require a machine which will break these compacts into the granules. These two requirements are always there in case of dry granulators. Now firstly we will look first dry granulator, that is slugging. This is a simple technique, slugging. The dry powders can compacted using a conventional tablet machines. Whatever the tablet machines we are having, we are compressing our dry powder in that tablet machines and converting them into granules. The more usually a large heavy duty rotary press can be used. Heavy duty rotary tablet press we can use for the preparation of slugs we called it as a slugs, or we can call it as a flakes. Okay, this process is often known as a slugging. The compacts made with this process is termed as a slug. Means whatever the compacts, flakes we are preparing by this process, that compacts are called as a slug, and that's why this process is called as a slugging. Now slug, whatever the slug form in this particular dry granulation method, typically have 25 millimeter diameter. Means their diameter is about 25 millimeter, and by about its thickness is about 10 to 15 millimeter. That much large we can say slugs we need to prepare. Then a hammer mill, or sometimes we are again also using your oscillating granulator, is suitable for breaking the slug. A hammer mill or oscillating granulator, here I didn't mention the oscillating granulator, but sometimes oscillating granulator is also used to break the slug. Okay, this is an old process. This is very old process for preparation of dry granules, sir. But nowadays it is replaced with a modern process like a roller compaction process, or we also called it as a chill sonator process. Now we will see the video of this slugging process. Just look at the video, you will get a clear idea. Now in this particular you can observe, firstly what we are doing, milling. We are doing milling of all, cutting our all drugs and excipients, and we will mill together, we will mix together. We call it as a milling by using cutter mill. Then pre-granulation stage, blending uniformly. We can blend them in a suitable sigma blend mixer, and we are blending our all mixture. Then we are going to for the slugging. Slugs are large. We can now, this is heavy duty tablet machine. By using that, you can observe here slugging large. We can form a slug by using this heavy duty. Here you can observe, this is a heavy duty slugging machine. By using that we can able to prepare a slugs. Okay, that slugs will get able to prepare. You can observe here. Okay, these are the slugs which will get to here. Now screening, these slugs will get passed through the oscillating granulators, or by using hammer mill. Okay, now screening. Generally we are adding them, teeth slugs, form the slugs, these slugs we are adding it in a oscillating granulators, and we will get the final granules. Okay, now mixing with the lubricants, finally we can add lubricants and in disintegrant after completion of your granulation process for its better efficiency. Again we are mixing them by using the sigma blade mixer. Okay, granules we are adding, then we are adding our disintegrants. We are adding, then we are adding lubricants. Okay, and then we will mix this. Now we are going to mix this, and you will get a final dry granulation blend ready for the further compression of your tablets. Okay, now this is a dry blend, and now you can do the compression by using compression machine or tablet compression press. Okay, this is all about the slugging method. We can call it as a slugging method. Now as we have said that this is an old process, and it is mostly replaced by a newer techniques, that is roller compaction process, or we also call it as a chill sonator. Now we will start with the roller compactor. Now in this particular you can observe roller compactor machines. Here you can observe, this is a hopper. Okay, upper feed hopper. Here we can feed our powder material by using this horizontal screw and vertical screw. The powder is fed over here. Okay, here there is a two compaction rolls are available. This is one and this is one. They are rotating in a opposite direction of each other, and by using this pressure applied knob we can adjust the distance, or we can adjust the pressure applied over your powder so that it will get converted into a flakes, or we can say compact mass. Okay, and then initially there is a pre-breaker. The whatever the compact mass are formed, these are little bit breaked by using this pre-breaker, and then it will reach into this granulator area actually, and that granulator area again having a blade which will chop down, and a screen. Through that screen, it will forcefully pass through this particular this particular flakes, or we can say slugs, through this screen. And then screening from that, this particular granulator will oscillate, and which will separate the product, what product you will require. That overs means those granulation which are of oversize, these are called as overs, and the fines. The overs and fines is again feed up, so that it will give you a product size of granulation. Means it is continuous process till the all product will get converted into a uniform size of granules. Here you can observe what does it mean by the overs. Overs means that the granulation which is of oversize, that will get separated in this particular equipment. The product means the granulation which we want the particle size, means whatever the size of our particle product, that is our finished product, we can call it as a product. And fines means the granules which are undersized, which are very fine, these granules are also separated, and then these overs and fines are again fed to the granulator, so that it will again get compressed, again get braked, again get screened, and get converted into a product. This continuously revolve. For that there is a original powder feed is there, then recycling system we will require, so that it will recycles overs and fines again and again in the chilsonator, and it will get convert your granules in a uniform size. Now we will look a video, you will get a clear idea about how chilsonator will work. You can observe, this is actually material container. Okay, this is your material which we want to convert into a granules. Now this auto suction will suck this material and feed it over here in a feeding chamber. Now how this feeding chamber will feed this material to the roller compactor? Now this is a vertical screw. We have seen that horizontal screw is there. This horizontal screw will put the material here, and this vertical screw will feed down the powder material towards the roller compactors. And we are also applying air pressure, so that material will uniformly get filled in a to the powder through the compression rollers. Now these compression rollers will form cakes like this. Okay, this form of cakes, this is a pre-break. The cakes will initially pre-break. By using this, you can observe material check, the cakes form is of optimum size or not. You can check it by here. Now these cakes are formed. This is a pre-break, you can say crusher. From this, initially the cakes are breaked. Pre-break condition, you can say. Now it will come into the granulator. Actual, here is a granulator. Generally it is oscillating type of granulator and screens. Okay, by using that, the powders will get converted, or these flakes will get converted into a granules. Okay, these granules, again there is a separate mechanism for the separation, like this, containing a sieves which will rotate in, and that will separate the different sizes of granules. Okay, look at the mechanism, how it will separate. Now this is the oversized granules, we call it as overs, then medium sized granules and perfect granules. Okay, these are the perfect granules, means this is our product. Now this medium size and this oversized will again get suction. It will again get sucked. You can look in this mechanism, again get sucked and again get fed to the compression roller, so that it will again form a final product. Okay, this is all about the chilsonator, and this is a Chamunda Pharma machinery. Okay, this will provide the this particular type of granulators for the manufacturing of granules by the chilsonator or roller compactor machine. Okay, now we'll look towards the some facts about the roller compactor. Now roller compaction is alternative gentler method. The powder mix is being squeezed between the two counter rotating rollers. In figure we have seen, this is a two counter rotating rollers. In through this we can force this material, then to form a compression sheet. We can observe it in the video also, we will get a compression sheet. The roller rotation speeds can be adjusted to allow variation in the compression time as the material phases passes between the rollers. You can adjust the rotation speed of your roller, so that how much time it will given to the pass this material through the rollers, we can adjust that. Then nextly, the roller rotation speed can be adjusted to allow variation in the compression time. Then additionally, the roller pressure can be adjusted and is maintained constant during the run by means of the hydraulic constant system. We can make it a constant by using hydraulic control system. An oscillating granulator used to break the sheet form and convert them into granules. Okay, whatever the oscillating granulator we have seen in high speed granulators, these granulators are used to break the sheets form in a chilsonator and make them into granule. A separation of fine small powder particles formed during this size reduction stage is often necessary. Means whatever the fine size of particles are there, we need to separate them continuously, and whatever the oversize, we can feed them into a granulator, oscillating granulators, and again we are breaking them down into a desired size of granules. Okay, this is all about the roller compactor and the techniques used for the dry granulation. Okay, this video is also I am recording. This video is also available on my YouTube channel very soon, so that you can able to revise it again and again. This is all about today's lecture, that is equipments used in a granulation, or we also called it as a granulators. Is there anyone who is having any sort of query or any sort of question? You can, session is open for the question answering. You can answer me it now. You can question me now, I will answer you now. Is there anyone who is having a question?